Good morning.
Thank you.
How are you? Okay. I understand that your air conditioning is not working and the outdoor unit is not coming on, according to your husband who left a message yesterday.
Yeah.
Is the thermostat on or off right now?
It's on.
It's on?
I don't know if he turned it off. I don't know what he did.
Let's go see the thermostat and then I go outside. Top of the stairs, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
At least we had all the fans going.
Alright. Indoor blower came on.
Yeah, the blower's working.
78 and it's 70 in here. And the filter is clean. Coleman. I swear they should stick to camping equipment with their, especially with their micro channel coils. I hear not a effing thing. But we have a high pressure switch and a low pressure switch in there. And if this micro channel coil is leaking, No bueno. Let me get my, you know what? I'm just gonna check to see if there's any pressure right there. What do you think? Ow. Yeah, there's pressure in there. All right, so maybe. Maybe, just maybe. Well, let's get the tool bag. Yeah. Sounds like a Coleman. This is the piece of toilet paper that I took to dry up a little bit of water on the floor when I took the pump out to check, see if it was a clogged float switch in it, but it wasn't. I'm gonna show you in a little bit later the inner workings of that condensate pump, so you see how it works. But first, using my digital psychrometer, let's get an ambient temperature. 75.6 degrees. Let's check our discharge temperature on top of the condensing unit. Almost 90 degrees. All right. Is she beer can cold? She sure is. Condensing too. You know what? I would like this to be hotter, but it's not. Interesting.
Bathroom, 2 degree difference, 60. Kitchen, 63.5. 58.5. Second floor bathroom, 57. And the return, 75.
Not too shabby. I think I got a great delta T going on inside between supply diffusers and return filter grill. Yes, the farthest runs, the first floor bathroom and the kitchen, the warmest, kitchen being especially being the warmest, but upstairs we have a average of 58 degrees. And on the first floor, we have an average of 60 degrees. And we have a ambient return temperature of 75. Reading 78 at thermostat, the wall's kind of warm. We're good. A float switch on the condensate pump really prevented a significant amount of water damage here. It's very important you have the right safety devices on your HVAC equipment, because a leak like this, or a failure like this on a condensate pump would have caused a significant amount of water damage, especially if left no notice. For example, the family is on vacation or even at work for the day. If that pump failed at 7 a.m., 6 a.m., 8 a.m., and the air conditioning system was left running all day, you would have had probably a couple gallons of water dumping through the second floor to the first floor, taking out the hardwood floor, the sheetrock walls, the paint, the wallpaper, everything in its path. And imagine if they're away on vacation, even worse. So if you have a central air conditioning system, you need to get rid of that condensate, the humidity that the system removes in the process of extracting heat from the house. Have a float switch installed on your air handler, on the drain line. Or if you have a pump, make sure it's wired for that float switch so it kills the system and doesn't allow for cooling, thus the creation of more condensate, more water in the process. If you live in the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area and you're tired of getting bamboozled by your HVAC contractor, I want you to pick up the phone and give me a call, 516-348-6300. You can also save time, book online at pipedoc.net. My name is Mike Dyke. It's been a pleasure sharing this service call with you, and I'll catch you in the next one. Be well, God bless, stay safe.